So Gautam, according to the Hay Group study, leaders in manufacturing believe that there is tremendous scope for increase in productivity in manufacturing through change and improvement in leadership styles. The study also points out that most of the manufacturing leaders overuse directive leadership styles. How do you think can managers in manufacturing work with different leadership styles to improve productivity?
Yeah, so I think you're right. I think I see a lot of managers use the directive leadership style, and I call that a quick fix style. I think one of the reasons is I think managers have a very strong shift orientation, as I call it, and I think that directive style actually comes from them, from that orientation. I think the bigger issue is not just to look at the directive style, but also look at two other styles, which is the coaching style and the participatory style. And I've realized that those leaders who do extremely well are those who are able to flex these styles. I think you're right, the directive style is a necessary evil in manufacturing, but I think it needs to be solidly backed by a couple of other styles, and one should be able to know when to use the style, under what situation. Unlike manufacturing, when one sees in services, the style is more participatory and coaching, and it's only in a firefighting situation that one begins to see a directive style. I think it's more a 80-20 in manufacturing versus a 20-80 in services, where I would say 20-25% is directive and the rest is the different style. So I think there is a big difference, and I think leaders need to be aware of this, because these are more short-term styles in terms of being more directive, and I think they need to look at a more long-term view through coaching, through team developing, through delegation, through empowerment, because all these elements come out of these styles.
That's a great point, Gautam, and what we have also found was that directive style is self-empowering style, so the power is centered around the individual, whereas in the styles that you just mentioned, coaching, participative, it's about socialized power, so empowering others to deliver results. So that's a great point.
Yes, and I think it's right, because if I remember reading your survey, you also spoke about the demotivating stuff around what leaders do to their team, and I think this self-empowering style actually tends to demotivate people, and I think it pulls away the motivation from the employee to the manager, where it creates a sense of dissonance, and the idea is actually to make sure you push the empowerment back to the team, so that they're able to do better and they're able to do things quicker for you, whereas you have more time then to think long term.
So that's where the coaching and the participative style, yes, actually shifts the power balance.
Yes, it needs to shift the power balance, and I think there is a lot of hierarchy and there is a lot of power orientation that happens in manufacturing, and I think a lot of this directive style actually stems from hierarchy and power orientation, and that's a big mind shift change that leaders need to look at, and that to me is the true manufacturing renaissance or true Make in India. If I look at Make in India from a cultural angle or from a leadership angle, it's more about taking the power away from the leader and then sharing that power through a more participatory approach, rather than just taking everything and centering it around I, me, myself.
That's a great point. So actually, at the root of Make in India, it's about sharing power and empowering others.
Yes, that's right. Yes.